everyone, it's Roseanne. I'm here to share a fabric album that I created for my swap with Miss Loretta Allen. If you don't know her, please go over and visit her channel. She is extremely an extremely talented young lady, and she's a crazy quilter, and I just love all of the things that she does. And I'm making flowers over here for my next series. I'm going to have a gypsy kit with all my colors, and it'll be a series, and I'll have 3 kits available, and I'll create from the kit. But anyway, this is for Loretta. I've got a bunch of updates I want to tell you about the house and the auctions and all that, but this is going to be for Loretta. Okay, so this is the fabric album that I created for Loretta. I hope you love it, sweetheart. And it was just made. I used some of the beautiful fabrics that Tama gave me, and items from many, many ladies. This was Gail. This was Judy Nose. I believe this was Judy Nose. I just coffee dyed it. Laces from my store. These are from my store. These were from Rosella, Nola. I've got many, many layers here. This is from my store. Dangles again from Gail. Different curtaining from Nola. Beautiful fillet from Judy Nose. And then this was from Angela Lanier, this flower. And this is a new, one of my new favorite wedding dress that I just recently, well, not recently, it's been a while now, that I purchased in a de-stash from Janet, Nana Jail 54. And look at this beauty. Oh my gosh, it's so beautiful. But I have cut little bits from it here, here, and here, and here. So yeah, that's what that is. And then this is just a little tiny, rolled rose that I made with, I think that's some gold fabric that I got from Nola. It has these little sparkles. This is a lace from my store, coffee dyed, and again, vintage lace. This lovely lady had, she was holding a bouquet. And so I created a little ribbon rose, and then I put these little bits here. I tied on a button there. Lots of little hidden things. A little piece of my mom's vintage jewelry that I've started to use. And then these are just connectors from my doilies. My doily set. And just more beads and rhinestones and beautiful bits of lace here. Yeah, okay. So then let's go inside. And again, just more items from my friends. And this is from my store. And this is a gorgeous lace from Nola. I just love this one. Another earring. Beautiful little bits of scraps. And Loretta does crazy beautiful beading in her crazy quilting, so some of these I glued, like these I glued on, and these I sewed on here. So, and then more of the wedding dress, and little this little flower here was given to me by Roses and Tea, and Tea and Roses, Teacups and Roses. Oh my gosh, quite a long time ago. I use them very sparingly. This was from D. Elegant Embellishments. This particular piece right here was from some fabric that Gail recently sent me in my recent happy mail. And this is a Natasha Scrapbook Corner lace, and curtaining again from Nola, and just little bits hand-sewn beading there with just little scraps. I found this piece of fabric, which is this one I've been cutting up in my recent yard sales. So I've been using little bits here and there. My doily. Yeah, little bits of scraps. This is the center of this doily here. Yeah, just little scraps. I'll do a close-up here. And then this side, this is fuzzy from my store. More just scraps, tons and tons of scraps. And then this was, I have lots of fabric swatches. So this is part of my book of fabric swatches. And more wedding dress. More Nola, beautiful. This guy. So pretty, I love this. And then this one is up here. This fabric right here. And I put little pearls, coarse rhinestones. And there are, let me do the close up. And then just little bits of dangles. There's both pages. This is pocket pages, and I started filling it up. So she'll get just little goodies in there. This is some of my vintage lace in my store. Natasha's Scrapbook Corner. These are applique, flower appliques that are in my store. I think this one is sold out, this one. So I just repeated. This is a beautiful, really long rose. It's like 8 inches. I think it's 8 inches long. Beautiful lace in my store. I finally got it back in. The vendor just, I don't know. The vendor takes forever when they make that particular lace. I don't have one to show you. I'm sorry. I should have been more prepared. But it's a really pretty long lace that I have in my store. I just avocado dyed it. These are avocado dyed. And then some of my rhinestone. These are all hand beaded. Little flowers in the center there. And then these are all hand beaded sequins and beads that I put at the top of the pocket. And then more of my fabric swatches and coffee dyed lace here. This was a curtain I found a long time ago, and I cut it to make dangles. Beautiful. And I think that's it. That's all I can say about this one. Okay, and then the last pages here. And this is little scraps. And this was a lace that sold out in my store. This was a lace that was given to me by D. Elegant Embellishments. This is the wedding dress, my doily. And then just little tiny bits here. This is from my store, and when I saw this picture, it reminded me immediately of my bell lace. This is coffee dyed. This was a rose that Nola sent me. She sent me a little sprig of these roses. And then I think this is from Natasha's Scrapbook Corner. It's just little scraps, little bits. This again is a lace from my store. It's one long flower that has dangles. So I just cut it, and this is avocado dyed. And then this was, again, D. Elegant Embellishments. And then this is a lace in my store here. And then that's just a cut-up doily and some scraps. And then this is some vintage lace. And this is vintage lace here that was shared by Judy Knows. And on this side, more vintage lace, coffee dyed, avocado dyed. This was given to me by Nola. There are the few scraps that I have left. It was a big curtain. More coffee dyed lace bits here. My doily. Here I made little scrolls with a little flower. And then this is a lace from my store. This is a... Nola had shared some butterflies with me, but I also have this in my store. And then this is a little muslin rolled rose with a little green rhinestone. And there's a green rhinestone there and a green rhinestone there. Another rolled rose. And this is just some curtaining that I turned into a flower with scraps. And then this is more of this. And also right here on top of the leaf. And then here I made just a little tiny envelope with a little bead. It doesn't open, it's sealed shut there. And that's it. I love all the little details. That's my favorite when I create books, is to make a bunch of tiny little embellishments and create tiny little details. This is hand sewn, and this is the center of one of my, I think it's this lace here. This lace here, I just cut out one of these and added it there. And then I sewed the little beads on every one of the spokes there. Kind of flanked this down. I think that's it. That's all I can say really about this this page. Layers. And then you know, every time you stop the video, you keep saying, God, I should have said that, I should have said this. This is the back, and again, I'll have my name or something down here inconspicuously, the handmade by. This, again, I don't know if I said this fabric is from Tama. So, this is my little book. I hope you like it. Loretta, let me see if I can just go through it really quickly again so you can see all the pages. And there's that. Little dangles and lots of little textures and little beading and me and my dimension. I always have to have dimension, different textures. So this is my book. I hope you like it. And then the surprise see if I have enough time is a wall hanging, a little wall hanging, and this was made with goodies again. My store, and this is scraps from Mamie. This was that curtain from Nola. This is from Nola. My doilies here. I just put two down and I left the little connectors. And then just layers, layers, layers. Vintage lace from Rosella. This is vintage lace from Rosella. And then this was a piece. I think this is my last piece that I had from Nola of this. I think it was a sleeve or a curtain or something. I just love this. Really, really love this. It's so soft, and I think it's the square that I love so much. And then, as I said, these are scraps that Mamie had sent me in one of my parcels. This is Natasha Scrapbook Corner, Nola. And then this is my lace in my store. I think it's sold out. This is the lace in my store that I believe is sold out. And this one is still available. This is in my store. It's a flower, and it has a bunch of flowers that I cut out. And then this was given to me by Lily, this flower. And these two flowers are from Janet, Nana JL54. And this is her wedding dress I got in the D-stash. And rolled rose. And this was from Janet, my cottage crafts, Jeanette. And then this little piece here was from Vanka. And then some beading. I have an acrylic frame there. And I have a little birdie there. And these were my own molds. And then this one was given to me by Teresa Moss. This beautiful flower there. She shared that. It was Teresa Moss or it was Sherry Gort. I can't remember. One of the two ladies gave me those pretty molds. Flowers. And I think it was Teresa Moss because she gave me some butterflies as well. Lace from my store that's coffee dyed. More of the beautiful wedding dress from Janet. Lace from my store. This coffee dyed ruffle. And then this is just some muslin torn, and I wove some of these scraps, or some scraps from something, with the lace, the rose lace in my store, this little rose lace. And I kind of intertwined it. And let me see what else. I think that's all. Layers. This curtaining was from Nola. I layered it over the base piece. And this base piece was a blanket that I cut up. And then there's my little tag. Here I'm going to put like a little charm. And this is where she can hang it. And then there'll be a little charm hanging there. So let me do the close-up here so that you can see the details. And, of course, dimension and layers, layers, layers. It's just little bits everywhere. Little pieces of different fabrics and this piece, doily, there's a doily down there, there's vintage laces, more little bits here that I sewed around the pictures. Loretta loves rickrack, so I wanted to include the rickrack in the photo. This little details. Beading. These were all glued on. Vanka. So I think that's it. I don't know what else I can say about this particular piece. I hope that you like it, Loretta. I had so much fun creating these for you. And I just love all the layers, all the textures, all the different tones and avocado tones and coffee tones and tea tones. And I love the way this came out, this little dangle feature here on the end. So yeah, I hope that everybody enjoyed seeing my two items that I made for Miss Loretta. I hope that you love them. And thank you so much for this swap. I had such a great time, and sorry it took so long. I just wanted to make sure I get all the little details and all of the everything just so for our swap. Okay, thank you again, everyone. God bless. And thank you for the thumbs up and your sweet comments. Bye, everyone.